Hey guys, it's Amber, and I'm getting ready to work on day 31, which is going to be my last day for the album. It's our Christmas with the kids. So I've got a lot of photos printed. I don't really have a clear plan yet, but I thought I'd share what I've got so far. So I have to start with being on the back of my day 30 here. So I'm going to have several 3x4s. I am also working with my super awesomely adorable fireplace that I created. It's one of the first layouts I made for this album, with my little lights that turn on. And this also slides up. My staple light catches here to reveal the little fire under the fireplace. So I never punched holes in it in case I wanted to change my mind on which side it's gonna go on. But I have two enlargements here. I'm thinking that this page will probably be the one that goes across from it. Just an entire shot of our Christmas with everything, you know. You can see the fireplace and the tree all decorated. I also printed another one of these templates from Allie's 2021 December set, the 10x8 set. I changed up the sentiment that was on here and dropped in a red pattern paper that's also from that kit. Also removed the digital file and created my own so I could add some journaling. The holes will probably go on this side. I chose this picture. I actually had them originally switched, but I chose this one so I'd have room for the holes and it wouldn't be going through my piece. I did pull out the circle. I'm considering doing something like this with this green felt star from another kit that I have. Or, I was digging through some of my stuff. This is not from this set, but I was actually really liking this tiny bit of sparkle this added, and maybe a wooden tree. This is actually from the travel collection, but I set it aside with my December daily stuff in case I want a tree. So I thought that might be kind of cute. So I'm still obviously making those decisions. As far as everything else that I have here, I have a bunch of, I'm probably going to be using at least two of these divided page protectors. Plus, of course, I'll have all those 3x4s, but I went through my stash and I picked out the things that I still wanted to use. So I've got hearts, I've got a couple more of these tags left, and these tags as well, in case I go through with them, you know, together back to back. I have a couple embellishments here that I really liked. The patches, the star, my last nested chipboard star from Star Kit. These nested chipboards. This is like a die cut from at least two. I got a squeeze in there somewhere. I've got more of these canvas strips. And I'm not gonna use all of this, obviously. It's just stuff that I pulled out of my stash. More of these chipboard pieces. Some stickers, these two die cuts, this die cut, two of these, this, the vellum. I definitely want to try to figure out a way to incorporate the vellum. So I know I won't be using all this, but I wanted to have it right here on hand so that I remember to use some of it. I also have these guys. A friend that I traded some product with sent me just like, it's almost like a coaster with a super adorable winter cat on it. So I have that tucked in there. I also am considering, instead of using this as is, maybe cutting it into two 3x4 transparency pieces so I'd have some see-through pockets. This is going to go in at the end. I'm just going to figure out a little cute stamp to stamp all these off. Chipboard stars from the Star Kit and chipboard from the Paisley Press Kit. There we go. A few journal cards here that I've been saving for Christmas Day things. This is a pattern paper from the main kit that I printed out. Two more of these left from the main kit, and then I've got my 3x4 photos here. I'm also probably going to be doing a couple flip-ups here and there just to help get more stash used. But I've got presents under the tree, the kitties, some pictures of us. Some of the presents and the kids opening. So that's 11 3x4s. So I'm thinking I'll have two of the pages that look like that first one. And then I have some 4x6s here. I have these three cards that are all from the Paisley Press Kit. I have a shot looking down at the presents under the tree, fireplace, another printed pattern paper, the kids by themselves, the kids just as we started opening, one of the teens laying under the tree, Jared's big present, and then just like a shot of like the aftermath. And then I also have a few 4x4s. Like I said, this is gonna be multiple pages, but yeah, this is our Christmas. This one I'm gonna trim down. I printed it a little big, hoping that this would be small enough to punch out into a 4-inch circle, but it's, I'm either gonna have to reprint it or just use it as a square because I didn't really give myself quite enough room for it to have more red around the sentiment. So, and then a few more of the kids. I love like her surprise excited face with some gifts. Two more of the kids opening here. And then these were also from the journal card set combo. This one said moments, and then I just added some journaling about seven little memories and the no Grinch, keep your grouchiness to yourself. I've been wanting to use that as well. And they're like the same green. So I printed both of those also because it's stuff that I just really wanted to use. So I have a lot of configuring to do. A lot of that will probably be off camera as I figure out which pictures go where. And then the one thing that I will need to figure out is I have basically three full-size pages. I need a fourth because, you know, two of these will be back-to-back. I need another one for the back-to-back on the other side. So it will either be the vellum being used as a pattern paper, or I'll probably have just a pattern paper from the main kit with the add-ons from my stash here to maybe have like a little breathing room so it's not photos and so many pockets. I did consider potentially, I hadn't used the canvas pockets yet, so I did consider maybe trying to put those in. I've got some Heidi Swap papers set aside here. I did really still want to use this, but I've done so many circle pages. I'm not sure I have the right photos or embellishments for this. We'll see. But yeah, I've just got some, you know, gray pattern papers left here to pick from, especially this one, which I've used the digital version multiple times. This one. And at some point, I really want to use these too. So those are probably my most likely to be used. There was a few more transparencies that I really liked, but I just don't have room for everything. You know, like I only have so much more space, even though this will be a multi-page layout. So I'm excited to play with all this. And I might, you know, I like those against each other. That's like the same color green. It's perfect. And the pops of red, kind of like that. So I'm gonna figure out everything, take you along for the ride, and I will show you what everything looks like when we are done. Okay guys, so I'm starting on the back of my day 30 layout with some 3x4 photos here. I decided to do a couple cat photos, one of me and Jared, and I have cat bracelets here, which was one of my gifts, but I'm gonna end up moving that to one of my last layouts and put a photo of the tree with some presents behind it instead. I'm going to apologize in advance. We are going to be jumping around a lot. I have 2 hours of footage that I culled down to 30 minutes. So it's going to jump from thing to thing that I'm working on. So what I'm trying to do here is find some nice deep red cards that will work together. And I also was really trying hard to add in these 3x4 transparency tags, which I don't end up using. Spoiler alert for that. But I'm going to end up changing my mind because it's going to feel like it's too much red going on, and I'm trying to decide like the order of how I'm going to be doing things. So you might see me flipping back and forth quite a bit as well. So right now I feel like I'm confident in what I had just been working on, and I'm going to start working on some of the 4x6 photos with the 4x4 photos and digital cards and product cards that I have all set aside and gathered together by size. So I'm going to be adding in that 4x4, well, I guess it's just a 4-inch transparency circle. I originally thought about putting the other one on the back and including an embellishment, but I'm going to end up using a card instead. And here you can see I'm grabbing one of my photo cutting guides down to 4x4 to help me trim that 5x5 card instead of doing a circle. And just trying to pay attention to which way people are facing in the photos, what looks balanced for color. Like right there, I have a piece of our tree cover, which is in red, and the card on the left is red. So I'm trying to make sure that they're balanced. So here I am trying to keep in mind too who's in the photo. So like Jarrett's featured heavily in two of those photos with like a dark red sweater. So I'm, you know, trying to put him together with a photo of Juliana who's in a brown sweater, things like that. Or the kids there are facing in. Here I was considering doing some flip-ups. I ended up not doing any flip-ups at all. I just added an extra page protector to get in everything that I wanted because I have the room, and opening up Christmas presents is a big thing for us, and it's one of my favorite projects to work on for layouts. So just working on figuring out where I want to put embellishments. I was trying so hard to make that 31 layer on top of that star, but it was like too big, so it was kind of like covering it up. So instead of using that red and green paper or any of the tags, I'm going to end up using a teal color tag from the main kit with some Heidi Swap plaid paper that I used on one of my more recent layouts right before our cruise. But I think I'm going to make that decision off camera. And I'm deciding also that I really wanted to use that die cut that was offered with at least two photos of the girls that I didn't size them to fit in here, but I just picked two that would work. I have that All Is Chaos, All Is Bright card from the Paisley Press kit. I wanted to use it on the pink and red side, but it was just competing so hard with those red and white lines. I stared at that thing for so long, it actually started to like hurt my eyes. But I ended up flipping it over and using the black and white side instead. And then I'm going to find some extra embellishments that will go with that, which you'll see shortly. So here I'm just trying to figure out what to put on the back of that wreath. And instead of the other one, I decided that that Grinch, no Grinching, 4x4 photo card would be a fun way to punch that out in a circle because the design is in a circle. So now I've jumped ahead and I've made some decisions and I'm cutting out these little scraps of plaid paper. So I'm filling in that card with some pad paper, my number 31, and then a red word phrase sheet from, I believe, last year's set that says Gift of Love or something like that. And then on the bottom right, I'm doing three of the wooden houses that came in that set, taped together on the back with a sticker that says, like, No Place Like Home or something, because we had been away. I was looking for something that said home for the holidays, but I couldn't find any stickers with the right sentiment, so No Place Like Home worked. And I put both of those chipboard pieces, or wooden pieces, I should say, on the outside of the page protector for some dimension. But I just thought that that was a nice color scheme, and it went well with the photos. So there I added a gold brad from Michael's Recollections collections of Sparkly into the center. I could have punched it through the photo, but I didn't want to. I didn't need to. So I just bent the flaps back, added some red line tape, and stuck that down in the middle. I knew I needed a little something to go on that star, and I was really happy with that color green and the simplicity of it. So now I'm pulling out my 4-inch punch. I'll have that linked in my Amazon supplies for you guys below. In the video, and punching out that Don't Be a Grinch. I thought that was fun. Not that the kids were being grumpy, but they're teenagers, so that tells you what you need to know. And I thought that the color went well because I think Caitlin was wearing a lot of black in the photos. So now I'm kind of just flipping back over and over again to see what I'm still missing and making a decision on that one there. So I decided to use one of the canvas pockets. I switched out the color green for a lighter color green tag. And I'm going to spend some time deciding what I want to go in the middle. I really liked that little tree, but I'm ultimately going to end up going with one of the fabric adhesive patches. And I'm just kind of taking care of some of these threads here that are like uneven. I'm not sure why I didn't end up going with the tree, but just looked for things that could dangle. And then since I couldn't make decisions on that quite yet, I'm going to jump to a photo that I hadn't originally printed out and decided to add on to the back of that red and white
piece. So what I had to decide is if the red and white stripes were going to face forward or if the tree was going to face forward. And so I had to flip around through my projects and figure out where it would lay best. And so I'm actually going to put this on the back side. So I really wanted to use that green nested star, and I'm using my 2.5 inch punch here to crop everything out. So both photos and the card. And then I'm going to play around quite a bit with trying to find some other things to go with it, because I know I want the green star, but everything I had for embellishments that I really liked was like red and white, or like it just wasn't working for what I wanted, but like it was too much red and white, so I needed to pull in some greens. So once I started going through my heart stash here, I found that paper die cut that says Christmas Loves, which I realize matches that nested star. And then I just need to find a third item. So I decided to use this 3x4 photo that I printed out of one of the main kit digital papers with this wooden tree. And I thought that would look great. So then I wanted to put three things, but I needed them to like kind of move your eye around the page. So this is what it's going to end up looking like: the star on top, the paper with the tree, and then I'm going to use that pattern paper there that I printed out onto photo paper as a backer for the heart. And then I'm using, and it's hard to see there, but some gold vellum behind the star. And I end up leaving that embellishment completely plain. I think I'm just double checking like one more time that I'm happy with my placement of where I'm going to be putting these. So I'm going to use some 1/4 inch double-sided sticky tape, and I put pieces between all the circles and around the edges so that I can just lay it over the piece like that and pick it up, basically, and smooth it back down. And then because it's covering the adhesive, I kind of re-added a new piece and realized there that I missed some in the middle there to hold it in place. The nice part about this is that the adhesive catches the designs on both sides. So once I made all my decisions, putting this part together actually went quite quickly. So you can see I'm just pulling back all the adhesives, adding my gold vellum. That was from Hobby Lobby. It's like metallic, sort of. Both my photos of the girls, that one ended up being shifted down a little bit, so I had to cut off some of the photos so it didn't overlap with the vellum side. And then here I'm just deciding which way I want the pattern to face so that you can see some of the red berries in the pattern next to the green heart, so that it helps pull in some of the red. And I was really glad, I should say, to get back to decorating in red and green after all the blue of my vacation photos. It was really fun, but I love this holly pattern. I love that green pattern. And I have them strewn throughout the album. If you've been watching for a while, you would definitely are aware of that. So it felt nice to get back into the Christmas colors and to use up all the products that I really wanted to make sure I got in the album. So just added some adhesive to that chipboard star there and added it. Repunched the holes, because the holes this year were a lot smaller than they normally are and everything. So I repunched them all so they'd go through when you flip through the album more easily. So just adding on my adhesive, I use 1/8 inch tape along the holes from Gina K. That's linked in my information for you. And then 1/4 inch around the rest. Just helps keep everything really nice and secure. So the photo, I did intentionally print it a little bit larger. The dimensions on the die cut were a little, they weren't like exactly like 6 1/4 or 8 1/4. They were like a little bit off. So I wanted to have room to trim down, which I'm just gonna do here with my scissors. And then I will repunch the holes one more time. Okay, so now I've decided that I need another 6-pocket page protector at the end to fit in all the 3x4s that I had planned. So I definitely will end up using that transparency crop down to 3x4. But in the meantime, until I could make that decision, I was kind of playing with the pattern paper, which was that size, so I could visualize it more easily. So just trying to find balance in the photos. I have some funny pictures of Easton this year. That one in the bottom right-hand corner, like he's looking down at his stocking, but his hair is really long now, which is not the case. It used to not be that long. So you don't see his face in a lot of these photos, and that's just part of him, you know, being 15 and being a teenager right now. So I'm using, I believe it's Lawn Flan, that's that Santa Card is from. And it's got a nice little pop of like a light teal blue, which is also in that Holly card. Like the lighter leaves are kind of the same color, and so is the transparency. So I'm going to end up using these three cards, just not in this order. And I'm going to end up swapping out the photo of my gifts of the bracelet for the photo of like the girl's most expensive presents, like stacked up and hiding behind the tree, and Jarrett's present was hiding back there too. The story on the front photos is actually about the fact that Jarrett and I exchanged our gifts before we went on vacation. He gave me the bracelet so I could wear them on Christmas, and I got him a new pair of shoes to wear on the cruise, like a boat shoe kind of. So I had some photos of that stuff taken before our trip, but saved them to include here because it made more sense. So just still trying to make decisions and decide where stuff's going to go. Still wasn't 100% sure if I was using that transparency, but I knew I was going to use that pattern paper. But I decided to go for it, so I'm going to just trim off the part with the holes and actually leave it wider than 3x4 in case I end up needing it for another project. I'm just picking the part that had the most red berries for my project here. I'm going to put that in. Before I do, I realized it still had film on it, and it took me forever to pull that off. But now I'm going back to this photo of the tree, and I thought about using that Stories die cut, but the black just kind of didn't really go with the vibe. So just looking for something that can go on the photo there. And then I'm digging through my transparent hearts, and I find a dark red one. I wanted to use that Christmas Loves, but I realized I used the green Christmas Loves die cut and the Christmas Loves card. That was a 3x4. So I'm going to go with this dark red heart. It has like a little bit of a white line around it. And I decided to also grab these woven word phrase strips, which are really fun. So I'm going to back that onto some adhesive and some white paper so that it's not see-through. I like the white because it really makes the design and the color pop. And then I'm going to add some red line tape to the back of that word phrase and run it through my sewing machine. Anytime I've used one of these, I've run them through the sewing machine, and I really like the way they look because there's the way they were designed with the font towards the top of the design, there's room for stitching. So I've done all that work, and I used my 2-inch scrapbook tape to make it fully adhesive, which you've seen in previous videos. Run it through the sewing machine a couple times. One line of stitching white on white wasn't quite enough, so I ran it back and forth a little bit, showing you a little close up there. My original plan was to potentially trim the woven piece to match the outside of the heart, but I just decided to leave it as is and pop it up with some foam squares to, because the stitching was a little uneven. So here I'm making a final decision on my woven circle. I wish I had stuck the stocking ones down because I decorated it before I knew what my story was going to be. On those cards, I end up talking about how I like to lay out the presents under the tree. That's one of my favorite traditions. And then the other card is talking about how stockings are always my favorite thing to open at the end of all the present opening. So, jumping back to the last set of photos, which is the 6 3x4 pocket page, I'm adding journaling, talking about how Jarrett and I exchanged presents early before the trip and what we got each other. So that's going to go on the 3x4 card there from the main kit. I'm just using my tool there to put down that matte sticker paper, which is in my information. Trying to find a little embellishment that can go on there. On other cards like this, I've stitched, which I forgot to even consider doing, and I added wooden pieces. So I thought I would attempt like a green star or a wooden star, but I'm going to end up finding a little rubber piece from, I want to say 2017 or 2018, one that says memories and kind of goes with the lighter gray tone in Jarrett's sweater. Jumping ahead, here I've used my 4-inch roll of scrapbook.com adhesive to make this entire transparency circle adhesive. It's like running it through a Xyron machine, but I'll have that linked in my information for you. And I decided instead of just sticking it to the back of that Grinch card, that I would cut out a 4-inch piece of acetate, which is also in my bio. It's the same stuff Allie uses from Graphics. So this way the circles will stay in place and still be adhesive, but you won't really see much through the clear transparency part. So just getting those stuck down and in place. So just trying to finish up the little bits of things here. Pulling out a red chipboard piece from the Paisley Press Kit to add to the top of that photo. Just kept it really simple. And here, it's hard to see, but I'm using my tiny attacher to stick down the rubber pieces onto the bottom of that card there. This one's like not at full speed because it was just like a 40-second clip. And then I'm just showing you how I, once I've made official decisions, I'll glue everything back to back with my rolling dot adhesive and trim anything, because those white edges that you're seeing there drive me crazy. So everything in my album is set up that way. So here I'm adding a pleather sticker that said ho 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 from the Paisley Press Kit, and these woven patches on either side of the transparency set to get this page finished off and embellished. And really happy with how everything's coming together. So now I decided to go back and tackle the journaling for these cards again on the matte photo sticker paper. The cards are not 3x4, they're like 2.5x3.5. So I had to measure everything, set up guides in Photoshop, and then I was able to put two on one 6x4 piece of the transparency sticker paper. So just using my tool to get everything stuck down there and smoothed out, and then I use those pink non-stick scissors to trim around the edge. It helps keep everything from sticking too much. So then I used my 1/4-inch power punch to repunch the hole so that it'd be the same size. So just trimming all of that out and tucking them in. I would have preferred if I could have kept the journaling a little smaller, but is what it is. So adding on that last sticker there. And I was trying to decide what ribbon I was going to use, if I was going to use the same color for both. But I decided just to go with opposite colors of ribbon on each card. So green and white May Arts ribbon on the red and red and white on the green card. Just thought it was kind of fun. And I'll have that ribbon linked in my Amazon supplies for you as well. I think I invested like $15 or $14, maybe. Sometimes I got them on sale for $12 for these ribbons, and they last forever. I've been using them in my DDs for years, and I love the consistency, and it's a fantastic ribbon as well. So I used red line tape to adhere that canvas piece down, and then now I'm getting ready to use a stamp set from the 2016 December Dailies, which had a nice little size star on there, and Allie Edwards Redwood ink. Normally I would use like a stamping block or something, but I just decided to use her lid for this to check off the things from the holiday checklist card that we did this year. I think it ended up being like 13 things. I did consider using some of my chipboard stars, but I didn't want to waste them. So now I'm jumping to this Happy New Year digital package from the Jessica Turner. I will make sure that's linked for you guys and explain how to do it so you can get the free download. I printed it as a 8.25 by 7 inch wide, basically pattern paper. And then I'm using this Oh What Fun sticker, which was from the advent calendar, and that little picture of the kitty sleeping on the back of that holiday checklist. And on the right-hand side there, you may have seen I had a photo where I spread out all of my holiday cards into a wreath. Allie had done something like that with puzzle pieces on one of her layouts, and then I saw someone else do it with their holiday cards, and I thought that that would be just a great final photo, because I always use the 6x8 pouch to put all of our holiday cards in at the end of every album. So this way there will be a fun photo next to it showing them all. So added a few little chipboard stars there. That photo of the cat is like the only photo that I have from New Year's, which is so sad. We were just hanging out, you know, tired, didn't really take any photos because I was like done with after Christmas and our trip and everything. So I printed that at, I think it's 3.75 wide by 3 to fit onto that little paper there. So I'm just releasing it. I'm going to repunch the holes. And then I'm going to add that little Oh What Fun sticker to the top. And then I didn't want it to be too plain, so I used this little star washi tape that I think is from Felicity Jane. I'm not 100% sure. I'll see if I can figure that out. Put that on the bottom. I've been wanting to use it literally the entire album. And then I just use a little pen to write My Little Buddy Couldn't Stay Up Till Midnight. You know, just something really, really simple.
Okay, guys, so after all that, showing you a full look of what everything's looking like in the album. So I have my beginning here. Love how these little houses came out. That was inspired by one of Allie's days. It's getting a little tapered down here because of the cards, so I gotta keep an eye on that. But my digital full piece here. Then the full photo of the whole tree and the stockings. Got my little journaling in here. I considered adding some photos if I needed to, but love the way that these came out. Nice and simple. Finally used the real version of this pattern paper. My super cute little fireplace, which lights up. This does, you know, pull up for the fire underneath, which you've probably seen. This staple catches all the time. Just leave it. Here I ended up adding, I had two more of these pinked gold metallic stickers from the advent calendar. So one I used here and popped it up on Pop Dots. This says Merry and Bright. I didn't mention this in the video before, but this was one of the pieces that was a quote bubble from the pattern paper. Cut that quote part off and just use it like a die cut. Popped up. Here's that paisley impressed chipboard. Love this time of year with the shot of just the tree by itself. And I love how this came out as well. Just something fun, a different shape, you know, something not in a page protector. Added a Letter Hearts Be Light chipboard star. And a Love Spending the Holidays with You chipboard, all from the paisley press kit. And a Holiday Frenzy chipboard, showing kind of the craziness. And here, I'm a little bummed because this is on top of a black photo, so you can't really see how transparent it is, but still fun by itself. Showing how that came out. Added a little tab here. This is a really old tab from, I don't even think it has an official kit. I couldn't even tell you. But I was a little bummed because my ink kind of was like wearing down. I might consider restamping it and letting it dry longer, but it kind of got a little smeary, even though I let it dry for a while. Little photo of Saifi on the back. I love how this bright color kind of reflects these bright colors. Even though the fonts are different, it works. Then here's my photo of the Christmas cards on the back with my last little pinked circle. I popped that up on Pop Dots, but this one corner is really sticking. I might have to put something under there to hold it up. So added the season's greetings into the center of this one. And then my photo cards here, I added the little pleather sticker from the Paisley Press kit that said Happy Mail. So this is bulky. It's kind of making things warp a little. So it's something that I do have to keep an eye on, but I love the way this came out. The only things that I really have left to do now are I need to create a title page for my second album. I need to put in my pin here. I have my boyfriend rip the pins off the back and then he files them down. He does that for me every year so that I can include it in the album without poking it through anything. And that will probably go on one of the albums, like here-ish. Not sure which one yet, and I'll use like red line tape to adhere that down. And then I also have one of these to put in one of my albums too, once I make a decision on which one that is gonna go in. So I need my intro page. And then we are good to go. So quite a few products that I wanted to use and didn't get to use, but I'm gonna set them aside and put them in my project life. One of them was this. I still wanna try to use it. I don't know how or with what, but maybe as my intro, you know, with some white paper behind it. 'Cause I had something else in mind, but we shall see. So Thank you so much for watching and sticking with me through 31 days of layouts, and I will be sharing the final walkthrough of both albums with you once I get everything completely finished. And again, just thank you. I hope you really enjoyed it. I really had fun with these albums, and they are chock full of products and photos and stories, which I'm really proud of. So thanks again. Bye.